Hello, cyber citizens. Welcome to What the Science. In this episode, I am going to talk about quasars. So let's not waste any time and start the music. Quasars have a supermassive black hole at the center, which is millions to billions times the mass of our sun. It is surrounded by a whirlpool of superheated plasma about the size of a solar system and shines brighter than an entire galaxy. Sometimes they have jets of near-lightspeed particles filling the surrounding universe with giant radio plumes. History of quasars can be traced back to 1917. Between 1917 and 1992, astronomers found out that there are some objects in the universe which is as big as our galaxy, which emitted large amount of radio waves. Later on, we had our radio telescopes pointing at these objects to pinpoint them, but earlier telescopes didn't have a good spatial resolution and we were unable to pinpoint the exact location of the source. But in 1962, due to occultation, a phenomena in which one object is hidden by other object that passes between it and the observer, we had our moon passing through one of the brightest point, due to which now we could pinpoint the exact location of the source, and it came to be known as 3C273. With the exact position of the source, we turned our telescopes to this exact location to find more about the source of radio emission. The spectrum of emission from 3C273 were completely different from the spectrum of any star ever seen. So instead of calling it a star, they came up with the name quasi-stellar radio source, later on which came to be known as quasar. The spectrum emerging from 3C273 was redshifted, indicating that it was very far away from us, approximately 2 billion light years away. But even with that distance, it was bright. That means 3C273 should be emitting many galaxies worth of light from a very small region of space. So many hypotheses were given in order to explain this phenomenon, but the best plausible explanation came by the 1980s. The explanation says, consider a black hole of millions to billions times the mass of our sun at the center, and when the gases surrounding the black hole descends into it, they gain incredible speeds on the way, such that it is swept up into a raging whirlpool of gases around the black hole, which is also called as an accretion disk. At these incredible speeds, the energy of motion of these gases turns up into heat. This heat glow is so bright that we can see quasars from 2 billion light years away. Some of the gases around the black hole goes past the event horizon, but most of them don't, being converted into energy or radiated as light and also ejected from the poles of the black hole. Also, the exact appearance of this phenomenon depends upon our angle of observation. For example, if we see the jets perpendicular to our line of view, then we see a radio galaxy. If they are at an angle, then we see quasars. And finally, if they are pointed directly at us, then we see blazars. So, when a supermassive black hole feeds and blasts energy into the universe, it can be called as a quasar, blazar, or a radio galaxy based on our direction of view. So basically, all the three are different names given to a supermassive accreting black hole, which is also known as active galactic nucleus. But supermassive black holes are not always feeding, so black holes often run out of food, so the jets run out of power and shut down. Our Milky Way has a supermassive black hole at the center, but it is not active because it has run out of food. That's the reason why we don't appear as a quasar to any distant galaxies. But in coming 10 billion years or so, when Andromeda Galaxy and Milky Way collides, it is said that their supermassive black holes will merge together to form a new quasar, which will henceforth illuminate this part of universe. But one thing we can all agree upon is that quasars are awesome phenomenon, and there is more to it than what I have covered today. So feel free to share what do you know more about them in the comment section below. And if you like what we are doing, then please do hit the red subscribe button to subscribe to our channel, and also hit the notification button to get notified of all the recent activities happening on this channel. Also hit the like button if you really like the video. You can also watch other playlists from my channel by clicking on the link above. And to continue watching, please click on the videos appearing on your screen right now. Thank you for watching.